is Murray Brewery, one of Pakistan's most successful companies. It makes around 10 million liters of beer every year. Although it can be a dangerous business to run in a country plagued by Islamic violence, liquor business continues to flourish in Pakistan, registering an annual growth rate of 15 to 20%. Founded by the British in 1960, this Parsi-owned brewery was burnt down by Muslim protesters and even temporarily shut down. But it continues to survive prohibitions imposed way back in the 1970s.
As such, there's no risk. Why? Because we are a very, very legal entity. We are one of the biggest taxpayers in this country. And it is in the interest of everybody that the Murray Brewery, whatever it's doing, legal business, should flourish, should continue.
The country's black market is thriving thanks to the alcohol brought in illegally or sold to bootleggers by diplomats who sell a part of their legal quota.
It is not possible to give any figure, but you can have an idea from the sales we have made. The illegal alcohol which is smuggled is seized throughout Pakistan, and last year we seized around 89,000 bottles and cans of smuggled alcohol.
Apart from the minority Hindu and Christian communities, a section of the elite Muslim society also offer brisk business to the bootleggers. However, there are people like Hassan who make their own wine at home.
Available wine is probably, you know, it's cheap. It's cheap as in it's not good wine, and yet it's very expensive. Plus, it's a nice hobby. It's fun to make it. It's fun to drink it after you've made it yourself, because then you think, okay, this, for better or for worse, you know, I made this, this is mine, and I'm drinking it now.
It is indeed surprising to see alcohol sales booming in a country like Pakistan, where it's forbidden to almost 97% of its population. Bureau Report, WION.